from God. I want you to know the kingdom of God is at hand. Right now, we are living in 2021. And I truly believe that we are living in the last days. We are living in the revelation days. That's for the revelation 13:1 through 18. I'm just going to read a couple of scriptures where it says, and he calls all folks, small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark on their hand or on their forehead. Isn't that what we're doing right now? The DNA by the vaccine with a thousand men on mice. They're going inside your body and it's killing and destroying. Or a demon is going to step up and you're going to get a mark on the beast and go up in your hand, on your forehead. Amen. I want you to know we are living in Revelation time. But the Bible says, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you can be able to stand and do all the sin against the enemy. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but with the powers and wisdom and confidence. Amen. Thanks to God, this is where we are right now. We are wrestling against spiritual weakness in high places. In the name of Jesus, I want you to know the blood of Jesus put down the sword over forms that weapons that the enemy can try to put against us. It would not prosper. I want you to know things of God is trying to get together and pray like never before. My prayer promise is to pray and get into the Word of God, because the Word of God is the only thing that's going to keep you. You see what's going out there. It's the silent people, the vaccinated people, and the unvaccinated. They call the people that come together, black and white, Filipino, Hawaiian, Chinese, and Korean, to try to twist it and destroy us so we can come together and fight among each other. But I want you to know the devil is alive. No weapon formed against God's people shall prosper. Thanks to God, it's time to get into the Word of God. It's time to fast and pray like never before, because we are in the end times, and the enemy is trying to steal, kill, and destroy. But God says, I promise you, you want to have life, and life more abundant. That's why God sent his son Jesus to die on the cross for our sins. And on the third day, he rose with all power in his hand. Amen. If you don't know Jesus as your Savior, I want you to know now is the time, it's the best time to accept Christ as your Savior. When you hear him knocking at the door of your heart, that's me. Amen. And let him suck with you. Amen. You be his child and he'll be your God. He will cover you from the hands of the enemy. Amen. But if you're not saved, if you don't know Christ as your Savior, you're out there in the open field with the enemy can't destroy you. But if you get covered under the blood of Jesus, no Christ is your Savior, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. He will come and he will rescue you. He will bring you up out of deep waters. He will bring you out of the sacred of the world that deep. Amen. God will pour you out of whatever the enemy has tried to keep you in. I want you to know things about it. It's not a place like never before. Amen. We have to pray for our president and pray for our leader. Pray for everyone that's in authority, that God would touch their minds, that they would seek his grace concerning God and his word. Let's keep our children in prayer as they go to school. Amen. We cover them under the blood of Jesus. The blood covers the land. The blood covers the steps of the righteous. The blood covers the mothers and the fathers. The steps dependent on God. Amen. The things of God is trying to straighten up the dry right. Amen. Time out for prayer. And it's time out for prayer. It's time to pray like never before. I want you to know, thanks to God, you got a right to be free. I want you to know, prayer is God within you and in the sin world. Amen. It's time to straighten up and fly right. The Bible says, he that has a gift, let him hear it. What is the time to speak to the church? Don't you hear? Can you see it out there in the world? The Spirit is speaking especially. Amen. The Bible says, in the last days, people will be supposed to They don't want to hear the truth of the Word of God. They want to hear things that fix their ears and make them feel like what they're doing is all right. I want you to know the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life. I want you to know your fear will soon find you out. Amen. I want you to know you